to yin and restorative practice. So one of the things that I live with every day and deal with on a daily basis is living with somewhat severe anxiety and mental health challenges. And I'm very open about it. I talk about it on my website and use that as a tool to help channel the energy through what I love to share in the practice that is yoga, meditation. And some days, some weeks or months, even seasons or years, anxiety can range in so many different ways. And there are also many different strands of anxiety as well. Sometimes it just can take control of your thought patterns, your emotional sensitivities, your reactions to certain things. And even if we know better, sometimes we forget even when we know better. And in the yoga practices, the more that we can understand how to catch ourselves when we're in this pattern of behavior, knowing that we have control over how much we let ourselves get wrapped up in our own experience, that can make all the difference. So in this practice tonight, there will be a focus point on breathing and calming the nervous system, holding positions that can help to promote the body to unwind and to decompress. So my offering for you is to make sure you have two foam blocks, place them beneath your knees, a chip foam block, which is always helpful to have, and then having a bolster, a rectangular bolster to sit on and also to support the body. I have three bolsters that I like to use, but you could do a lot with one or two, and use blankets as well to help support the additional coverage if needed. So please listen to your body. We'll start in a seated position of your choice. I like to cross my ankles a little bit, not super tightly, and have my knees up on top. And then I lengthen through the crown of my head and root down through my sit bones, and you can find something similar to that effect. Have your palms facing down on your knees as a way to ground the energy down towards the earth and below. Roll your shoulders back slightly to lift the chest a bit and see if you can bring the sides of your throat back just a touch. Let your eyes become heavy. And it's okay. Let your organic human being simply be right now. Have nothing to prove to yourself, nothing you need to prove to me, because I'm not watching you. This is a recording, and even if it was a real class and I was in front of you, you really think that I'm focusing on any critical about you? Not at all. I might be feeling more critical of myself, which is also part of the practice to forgive and to not be critical to ourselves when we don't need to be. Take an inhale through your nose into your back of your body. Exhale through your nose or your mouth. take the right hand and take the right piece fingers to the center of the forehead at the brow point. And then taking the thumb and the pinky finger available, keeping the ring finger into the palm for alternate nostril breathing, Nadi Shodhana. We'll take an inhale through the nose and exhale through the nose, keeping the mouth sealed. And then we'll switch from side to side, taking a small amount of time to do that before we go into our asana practice. Take an inhale through your nose. Out your nose. Inhale through your nose. Seal the left nostril. Gently exhale through your right. Inhale through your right. Right thumb seals the right nostril. Exhale through your left nostril. One more breath from the right. Out the left. Release the right hand down to the right knee. Return the natural breathing. Cycles of your breath. And bring your palms to meet at heart center, lifting your sternum into your thumbs. Let your fingers spread wide as you feel the energy between the hands. And inhale through the nose for the sound of Om. Release your hands down to your thighs and let your eyes blink open. Coming off of your blocks, take the blocks to the front corners of your mat onto the floor. you can take your bolster as it is and place your bolster, if you like, between your thighs, bring your bum to your heels, and then nudge the bolster more underneath your chest as you soften to the ground for a child's pose, Balasana. This is one option you can take. Another option can be to take the bolster off to the side for now, making it more of a yin gravity in the body, and let your torso and your forehead come all the way down without any additional support. Let your forehead be heavy if you do this. And breathing into your belly as your belly massages against your thighs. If you ever need to come out of any of the postures early, simply do just that. Safely come out the way you came in. Find a place of seated or reclined or lying on your back that's comfortable. And come back to it when you feel ready to. Send your breath into the sensations in the body that are calling you, that are asking for more space to be breathed into. Taking another breath here in your child's pose. Come forward to your hands and your knees. Walking your hands back toward you and walking your knees into more of your hips width apart. extend your right leg back behind you and push back through the toes and stretch out the back of the right leg. And then take the left leg back. Center. From there, getting into our upper backs. From your tabletop, walk your hands forward in front of you, sending the hips back and above. And send your forehead down to the ground for mounting heart pose, Anahatasana. You can always support the forehead by bending an elbow, placing that forearm down so the forehead can rest on top. Or take a block if you like, if you find the forehead to the mat is too much intensity or not accessible for your body's proportions. One more breath here. Carefully draw one elbow back and forearm back, and then the other. Coming back up to your hands and your knees. Around through your spine to counteract a deflection. Let your hips and torso cat-cow in any direction, side to side, front and back, circular, here. Take a chip foam block underneath your knees so you can pad your knees. And then, mindful of the knees and the legs, begin to tuck your toes and bring your sit bones back to your heels. Bring the hands on top of the thighs, coming into toe squat. As an optional add-on, if you have a wooden doweling, place that doweling in between the pits of your knees, sending your bum back to your heels and adding a little fire, a little kick into the hamstrings and the calf muscles. And then you can take your hands on the doweling if you like, as you rock your hips side to side. Dowling feels okay, you can roll the dowling down a little bit further, finding a different sensation for the legs to relax deeper into. You don't want to be feeling any pain, so if the nervous system is saying to you that it's too much, be sure that you listen to those responses so you don't incur injury or anything damage in the body wise. Inhale. Inhale, lift up, take your dowling down, sitting back. Exhale. Lift up one more time. Take the dowling to one last spot right on the meat of the calf muscles. And sit back down, using your hands for additional pressure on the calves. Wiggling the toes now, rolling the ankles and the feet. the tops of your feet up. And then bring your knees back onto the floor, taking your chip foam block off to the side. And from here, take the tops of your feet down onto the ground. Tend your fingertips on either side of your feet as you roll your shoulders back. Lift your knees and shins off the ground as you inhale. And exhale. Back into table position. Shift your weight onto your sitting bones. Finding a seat of meditation is taking a few moments here, providing the body a moment to process that work so far. Sigh out the mouth. Bring your left ear to your left shoulder. Releasing the right side of the neck. You might feel appropriate to take the right fingertips out to the right side as you find length in the right side of the neck and breathing into the right side from there. Carefully roll the chin to the throat. And then taking the time as you bring the right ear to the right shoulder, left fingertips come out to the left side. carefully release your chin back to your throat. Roll yourself back up to center. Take a gentle seated twist by placing the right hand to the left knee and the left hand behind. As you inhale, press down through your hands to grow longer and taller. As you exhale, resist as you rotate around towards the left. Don't force it. See where your spine will naturally rotate, and then once you find your edge, staying there and breathing into the spaces between. One more breath here. Inhale to center. Place the left hand to the left knee and the right hand behind you as you counter twist to your right. Your right knee, right thigh. Take your right fingertips and lift your chest up. Exhale, rotate to the right. Again, playing with your edge as you find the sensations that come.
short breath. Inhale to center. Take your right hand to your right knee, left hand behind in an open twist to the left. Inhale to center. From here, uncross your legs, shake out your ankles. And then from there, come onto your right hip. Make your way onto your belly. And as you find your way into your belly, coming into Sphinx position. So take your legs back behind you. And take your forearms out in front of you. Point your toes back and lengthen your sternum forward and up. Take the tops of the feet down. And start to breathe into your lower back and your pelvis. Place a block beneath your forehead or a bolster beneath your chest, or you can stay as I am here without any props. So use your props if you want to add support and make your body feel more accessible if it isn't right now. Breath here. your palms, bring your elbows wide, and lower yourself down to your belly. Recover from that. Bend your knees and lay your legs windshield wiper from side to side. Back down to your legs. And there, find your two foam blocks, turn them on an angle facing in towards your lats and your armpits, and place them in a way where the angles of the blocks line up with the pectoral muscles, so you're not causing any pain. But there's a nice, fine balance of kind of a dull ache. And then place a chip foam block the rest of the forehead on top of once you do. You can take the arms around and circle them around, kind of explore those sensitive tissues around the pecs and the lats, and then eventually letting the arms come out at some angle that they can be still and relaxed. And then let your breath massage around the blocks. more breath here. Begin to release the blocks off to the sides. You take your chip foam block forward and sack your hands to rest your forehead on top. Take your arms out in line with your shoulders. Have a block nearby to support the right side of the head. Walk your left fingertips in towards your left side of your chest, rolling onto the right hip. From there, step your left foot in front of your right knee and take your block beneath the right side of your face. And this might be where you start and also stay. The next option, you can take the left arm up towards the ceiling. Turn the left palm away from you, bending the elbow and taking the left top of the hand behind your low back. And then you can roll forward and even lift your right hip off the ground and place your right hip on top of your left fingertips and breathe. And the moment it starts to feel too much, back off and ease out of the shape, out of the sensations. Finding that intelligent edge is super key in the context of yin-based yoga. Breath on this side. release your left hand and reach it up to the ceiling. Placing your left hand down, stacking your legs, rolling over to your belly. Let the right arm come back behind you, palm facing up for a moment. Big sigh out the mouth, belly breath. And take your right hand inside of the right pectoral muscle, roll onto your left hip, keeping your left arm in line with your shoulder here. Place your right foot in front of your left knee and take the block beneath the left side of your face and reach the right arm up to the ceiling. Turning the palm now, take the top of the right hand if you like and place the left hip bone over top without going too far into your sensation. Leave some space for it to increase in its depth. Breathing in and out. Thank you. breath here. Release the right arm up to the ceiling. Place the right palm down to the mat. Stack the legs. Carefully roll onto your bellies. Take the block off to the side. And with the armrest, taking both arms down now, palms up. And set the blood flow back through the arms, the fingers. Here, press down through your palms to come up to your hands and your knees. You'll start to find yourself back to our seat and sending the legs out in front. Finding your chip foam block and your foam blocks, take them more to the sides of your mat near the back, but keep your chip foam block so you can place your sit bones on top. Taking your legs out in front of you now, we'll start to take a forward fold. Now, one option is to bring your feet and your legs more parallel with your legs extended out, or you can take them as wide as your mat with the heels wide, coming into a wide-legged forward fold. Okay, so that's up to you to decide. Inhale, reach the arms all the way up to the lift of the chest. Exhale, bow and fold forward down the middle. Your spine round as you come into the shape you choose. Let your head hang if it's comfortable for the neck. Or support the neck and the forehead with a bolster or a block if you like. Yami invites you to come a little bit lower. Welcome yourself, that ability to explore. Last few breaths here. Up slowly, place your palms down by your thighs, roll yourself up one vertebra at a time, roll your shoulders back, take a moment here. Sliding off of your chip foam block now. We'll start to come into a restorative back bend, a version of supported bridge. So what that will look like is you'll take your two bolsters vertical, so top to bottom, up and down on the mat, like so. Make sure that you have your mat to support your head. Have an eye cover available if you do have one. And then you'll lift yourself up onto your bolsters and position yourself so your heels come to the edge of that front bolster. Walk down through your forearms. And depending on the length of your torso, you ideally want to have the base of your shoulder blades, the tip of your shoulder blades supporting on the bolsters. So that way the shoulders just remotely get supported on the floor. And you can start to figure out for your body where in your shoulders is enough support to be on the ground and where your lower back feels like it has enough support where it can settle into the back bend as well. And if that doesn't work, then always bend your knees and place your feet on the bolster for a bit more sturdiness, a bit more foundation. So lay around with your body, seeing where it feels comfortable landing, for the body to feel an ability to relax. Your legs turn out if you like. And then you can begin to settle into a longer position of rest. But if this doesn't work for you, you can roll onto your back and you can rest in Shavasana, or just take a block or a bolster beneath your sacrum and take a more traditional supported bridge. Another option is to take a chip foam block in addition to that underneath your head, which can also support the neck and open up the chest a bit more. Also take your arms in line with your shoulders into a T shape, which may feel better on the upper back as well. Thank you. bending the knees, place the feet to the floor. Lift up your hips and take the bolster that was underneath your spine carefully away as you start to roll yourself back down vertebra by vertebra to the mat. Hug your knees into your chest, your chin to your throat. Yourself back down to the ground. Bring your feet to the floor. And let your knees windshield wiper a few times to either side. Take a brief twist here. Send your left leg out in front of you straight. Bring your right knee into your chest. Take your hips over to the right and your left hand on the right outside of the knee. Inhale. Exhale, roll your right knee across to the left for a twist. You can extend the right leg long if you like, out to the side. Inhale to center, hug the knees in, bring your pelvis back to center. Send your right leg out long, move your hips over to the left and take your hands into your knee, back to your chest. Take your right hand outside of your left knee and thigh. Take your left leg across to the right now. Exhale. Maybe straighten your left leg out if you like. Center, bring your hips to center, hug your knees into your chest, chin to your throat. And place your feet down, roll to one side, and come up to your seat for a moment as we set up for a nice supported Shavasana. Take your foam blocks, the two of them, like so. Place them flat and wide so they're touching. So if you have a platform, place one and two and then three bolsters on top of them. Bring your legs as wide as the mat. Bring your legs up over top. Scoot your bum close. Bring your forearms back. Roll yourself down into Shavasana. You can apply that eye cover once again if you would like to use it. Take one more big breath into your belly. moving your eye cover to the side, hugging your knees back into your chest. Rolling over to your left side, pressing up to your seat. Bringing your hands to heart center, thumbs to your sternum. Checking in with your mental state, emotional state, the energy in the body. And place palm over your heart. So letting the palms come to touch your chest, feeling the warmth from your hands to your chest and the heart beating back into the hands. It's not always easy to tame and to calm the nervous system, the monkey mind, the A-type fire, the yang. Time and through consistent practice, we can tap into the yin side and the parasympathetic nervous system a little bit easier each time when we can reverse the energy and bring more equilibrium, homeostasis into our body, mind, and heart. Inhale to Om. Place your palms back together, bring your chin to meet your fingertips at your heart. Thank you so much for practicing. Namaste.